what he is. He's no king. And I tell you something, I'm still appalled at his recent actions on Monday Night Raw, Brain. You were there. You heard his comments. The Stu and Helen Hart.
Well, you know, I love it because he took Owen apart. He took Bret Hart apart. Now he made a fool out of the Hart family. He's tremendous.
Well, well, well. Welcome to another edition of the King's Court. And I am really looking forward to interviewing my next guest. Because you see, he is a man, well, at least I think he's a man, who used to strike fear into the hearts of every World Wrestling Federation superstar.
And he still does, for that
matter. Well, just to look at this man would send people shaking and trembling.
Not me.
But you know, lately there's a little something missing about this man. Lately he's not quite so scary. So I want to bring him out here right now and find out just exactly why. I'm talking about The Undertaker.
Oh, The Undertaker. Oh, wait a minute.
See ya.
The light. Weasel. Bobby, why don't you get up under there?
Get your hands off me.
Is that you? Let go of my leg.
Is that you?
Let go of my leg.
Let go of my neck. You got my shirt. Get your hands off me. Is that you?
Of course it's me.
Something's biting me.
No, will you stop that? Hey, the light, his presence. This is a little bit strange, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, there my pencil is.
Well, I've seen him do this before. Lights go out. This guy's got some very bizarre powers. And he is without his urn. He is without Paul Bear. Thanks to Harvey Whipman and company, namely Mr. Hughes.
Pretty good trick with the lights there. Where are the lights? Oh, great. First of all, let's get one thing straight. I couldn't warm up to you if we were cremated together. Get it?
Oh, he's hilarious, isn't he?
It's a little bit like Cousin It.
Well, Undertaker, I wanted to bring you out. Are you going to speak?
Be careful,
King. Never interviewed an oil painting before.
Be careful.
I wanted to bring you out here and just talk for a second about the fact that there's something missing. Something is missing. What is wrong with this picture? Shut up, you idiots. Speaking of these idiots out here, you know, people are usually measured by their possessions. You know what I'm talking about? Idiots like this work all their lives as garbage men or plumbers or whatever you all are, and they try to buy fancy things. They have these nice little possessions. Most of them end up with like a 67 Pontiac or something like that, but they're pretty proud of that. That's their possessions. And now I look at you, and I see that you don't have any possessions anymore. You got nothing.
Careful, Jerry.
So as far as I'm concerned, that makes you a big nothing. You understand me?
You're pushing the envelope
because
here, pal.
Because you see, something is missing. And I realize now what it is. Your urn that was your prized possession. It's gone. But you know where it is? A very close personal friend of mine has it. Mr. Hughes has it. And Mr. Hughes told me personally that he don't know what's in that urn now. But when he gets his hands on you, Undertaker, he's gonna shove you in that urn.
First of all, Mr. Lawler, you seem just a little bit too consumed with my personal belongings. If I was you, I'd be more concerned about how close I'm standing to death's door. And as far as you go, Mr. Hughes, you have something in your possession. something that belongs to me. Now, if you return this urn now, I'll bring you to your demise very quickly.
Sounds like a heck of a deal.
But, Mr. Hughes, if I have to come looking for you, I promise you, it'll be a slow, agonizing, painful death. Mr. Hughes, rest in peace.
Well, the lights have gone out. Frick, get up from there.
Get your hands off me, I told you.
I don't have my hands on you.
Hey, wait a minute. I found out what IRP means. That means Ross is a pickpocket. Give me my wallet back.